सो वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम जय कुमार, वर्किंग असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ईसी डिपार्टमेंट, रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग टेक्नोलॉजी, दिंडकल। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट हाउ टू डिजाइन द कॉम्बिनेशन सर्क्यूट्स। इन जनरल द रियल वर्ल्ड सिग्नल्स आर इन एनालॉग नेचर। In order to convert this analog signal into digital signal, we need A to D converter, that is analog to digital converter. So in the analog signal is a single quantity signal, but the output of ADC may be the multi bits. That means it consists of a number of bits, depends upon the applications. Yeah, you see. Actually, the combinations of consist of n number of inputs and m number of outputs. The m number of outputs, it depends on current input of n number of inputs, so it won't depend on the past outputs. It purely depends on the present inputs of the circuit. So the combination circuit made up of the logic gates like AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, XOR gate, XNOR gate. So one more thing, it doesn't have any storage devices. So consider the design procedure. First one is the problem statement. Problem statement is very important. So depends upon the application, that is the problem definition, we have to identify the number of inputs and outputs. So after the identification of inputs and outputs, you have to assign some variables to that. After assigning the variables, we need to derive the truth table. The truth table consists of all possible inputs and all possible outputs. After obtaining the truth table, we have to get the Boolean expression using KMF or Quine-McCluskey method. After obtaining the Boolean expression, you can obtain the logic diagram. So half order, it's a basic element. So half order is the combination circuit. It consists of two inputs and two outputs. So what we'll do, so we are going to add two binary bits A and B. It produces some results, sum and carry. So if you are add this, the sum and carry. So for the sum input, we have to map all the possible outputs into the KMap. That is for 00, the sum is 0, for 01, the sum is 1, for 10, the sum is 1, for 11, the sum is 0. So this table we obtained from the truth table. Just transfer the truth table into KMap. Now similarly for KMap for the carry. So this KMap for the carry, similarly just transform the truth table, the carry column, into KMap. For 00 the carry is 0, for 01 carry is 0, 10 the carry is 0, for 11 the carry is 1. Now we have to obtain the Boolean expression for the logic 1. For the sum input, so we have to logic 1, that is in diagonal, so we can't group into pair or quad or echel. So it's for this one the variable is B, here A bar, so that is A bar B. For this one the B value is B bar and this value is A, so the result is A B bar. So these are the two min terms we obtained from the KMap. So by using the Boolean expression, so we can simply denote it as XOR operation between A and B. Okay, now the sum will be the A XOR of B. Similarly, CAMFs for the carry. In carry, we have only one logic one. So in order to get the expression, just here in horizontal side B, in vertical side A. It's a true value. So A B. So this is the logic circuit for the half order. So this is the combination circuit. Here the inputs are A and B. The sum is one of the output and carry is another output. For sum, we have the expression A XOR of B. So this is the XOR symbol. And the carry is A dot B. So likewise, so we can design other logic combination circuits, that is the full adder. So full adder add the three binary bits. It produces same sum and carry outputs. The three inputs are A, B, C. The outputs are the sum and carry. So if you see the truth table, for it start from 000 to 111. So these are the all possible inputs for the full adder. So the sum first add both 0 A and B, then result should be added with the C. So likewise, we have to perform for all the inputs. For 000, we have the sum is 0, the carry is also 0. For the next input 001, if you add 0 plus 0, the result will be the 0, the carry is also 0. Again, if you add 0 with 1, the sum is 1, carry is 0. Similarly, 010 also. If you see the input 011, if you add 0 plus 1, the sum will be the 1, carry is 0. So if you add the C in with the sum, that is 1 plus 1, that if the sum is 0, carry will become 1. So likewise, you have to perform all the input, all possible inputs. So finally, you will get the sum, sums and carries. So now you have to transform this truth table into KMF in order to get the Boolean expression. Here we have the three inputs, that is A, B, C, N. So we need three variable KMF. So this is the KMF for sum input. So this is the KMF for carry output. So here the input variables are A, B, C. So for A is 0, B is 0, C is 0, the sum will be the 0. Similarly, for A 0, B 1, C 0, the sum is 1. So likewise, transform all the truth table values into KMF. Now we have to, in order to get the Boolean expression, we need group the logic ones. So here the logic ones are in the cell number 1, 3, 4, 6. So for the first one, this logic one for cell number 1. So the A value is 0, B value is 1, C value is 0. So the logic expression is A bar, B, C bar. For cell number 3, sorry, for cell number 2, the logic expression is the A value is 1, B value is 0, and C value is 0. So the minterm is A, B bar, C bar. Similarly, for the four ones, we will get the four minterms as shown in this PPT. Now we have to simplify this by doing some manual simplification using the Boolean laws. So if you take the A bar as a common term from the min term 1 and 2, so you will get the B bar C in plus B C in bar. So this is the XOR operation between B and C. Similarly, so if you take A is a common term from min term 3rd and 4th, you will get XOR operation between B and C. So finally, if you notice that the A bar B XOR of C in, similarly plus A B XOR of C in bar. So this is the XOR operation between A and combination of B and C. So finally you will get A XOR of B XOR of C. So this is the result of the sum output. Then we need to get the Boolean expression for the carry. Similarly, for 0, 0, 0, the carry is 0. For 0, 1, 0, the carry is 0. For 1, 1, 0, the carry is 1. For 0, 1, 0, the carry is 0. So likewise, map all the carry outputs into the camera. So now we have to group group this logical one. So using pair, quad, like this. So here we will get three pairs, that is, this is first one, second one, and third one. So this is the first pair. This is the second pair. And so this is the third pair. So the expression is AB plus BC in plus AC in. So for this Boolean expression, we have to draw the logic diagram. So for A XOR of B XOR of C in. So we draw the three input XOR gate which have the input of A, B and C in. The result will be the sum. Similarly for the carry output, so the inputs are A, B. So first generate A and B. So this is A and this is, so this is A and B. So this is A B, then B C in plus A C. So likewise you have to generate three minterms and add three minterms into using three input OR gate. So finally the output of the three input OR gate is the carry output for the full adder. Now we will learn how to design the higher order circuit using the lower order. That means you can construct the full adder using half adder also. So the full adder have three inputs, half adder have two inputs. The both full adder and half adder have sum and carry outputs. Now let us take a simple half adder which have the input of A and B, and the resultant will be the one of the input for the next half adder. So third input is the carry in. So the result of the second half adder is the sum, and the carry out of the first half adder and second half adder will be added together in order to generate the carry out. Now the corresponding circuit diagram for the above logic is this one. So full adder using half adder. So the sum is A XOR of B XOR of C. In order to generate the carry, first draw the first write the expression from the given logic obtained logic diagram, that is A XOR of B and operation with C in plus AB. Now expand this XOR operation. So A XOR of B is the A bar B plus A B bar. Then it should be multiplied with C in. So just multiply here, you will get three min terms. It's like this. Now take A is a common term from second, third min term. So you will get this Boolean expression. So by using the absorption law, that is A bar B is equal to A plus B. And this is the absorption law. So using this, we can simplify this expression into B plus C in. So again, just multiply into the bracket and you will get this in terms. Now take B as a common term from first and second min term. So you will get A bar C in plus A. Again, using the absorption theorem, so we can write A plus C in plus A plus C in. Now, so multiply the B into the brackets, that is A B plus B C in bar plus A C in. So this is the required expression from in order to generate the full order using two of orders. So similarly, so you can design parallel adders using full adders. So actually, the parallel binary adder consists it's adding the two inputs. That means one input maybe have the width of 2 to 3, or second input maybe have the input of 2 to 3, or a number of bits. So you can add the separate two numbers using the parallel binary adder. For example, so in this example, A is the 4-bit, B is the another input that also 4-bit. It's a 4-bit full adder. So likewise, you can construct the 4-bit full adder, 8-bit, 16-bit full adder by using full adders and half adders. So